Your pastor wants you to love that man. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you don't have to love your oppressors. All you have to do is love yourself. If you love your oppressor, you hate your people. You can't love the people that hate you and love your... Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, those are not nationalities. One is a color. The other is someone named after Spain, right? They called the Native Americans Indians. Indian means savage. So what they were telling you, that the people, when they came here and found them, they were calling them savages, right? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are not savages. You are not black. You are not Hispanic. You are God's chosen people, the princes and the princesses of power. You are the Lord's chosen people, right? You are the 12 tribes of Israel. Look at this sign, Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. If you can see yourself on this sign, you should. He wants to abuse you. Our oppressor is a natural homosexual. The European man is a natural homosexual. He's been abusing us since the days he can walk.
Are about to be unfolded.
We are at a time. Hey, don't touch that, man.
Right? We were given instructions. We were given instructions. Our instructions come from this book right here. Right? Our forefathers gave us instructions. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you need instruction. You need to learn your morality, your way of life. We had a culture. Read
Deuteronomy 27 and 1. And Moses, with the elders of Israel, commanded the people, saying, keep all the commandments which I command you this day.
Right. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are told to keep the commandments, right? Your Lord sent you a leader. He sent Moses to get us out of captivity. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the same captivity that we went through in Egypt is the same captivity that we're going through in Canada, in the United States, in the South Americas, in the Caribbean Islands. Everywhere we are is the same captivity. We are given instructions. We were told to keep the commandments of the Most High, right? Moses gathered with our elders.
And Moses with the elders of Israel commanded the people, saying, keep all the commandments which I command you this day.
You are told to keep all the commandments. That means you don't celebrate Christmas. You don't celebrate your birthday. There's commandments. There's laws. Just like you give your child at home instructions and you're expecting your child at home not to break it. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are given instructions. Now let's find out what happens when you don't follow these instructions. You're going to find out why the European man, why the devil the Bible speaks of, our oppressor, has been cruel to us. Our oppressor has been cruel to us since 1942. He started with the Native Americans. He came over and he took 1,100 of them and put them on slave ships and brought them to Europe, brought them to Spain.
It is not the truth.
Deuteronomy 28 verse 1. And it shall come to pass if thou shalt hearken diligently unto...
If you listen diligently to the voice of your father, just like you tell your child at home to follow instructions, the Lord gave Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans instructions.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments.
Right? You gotta observe and do all his commandments. The pastor, the pork-eating pastor who doesn't care about you, he's not telling you to keep the commandments. Ask him right now. He'll tell you the law is done away with. But he'll still tell you, pay tithes. Where are tithes? Tithes are found in the law.
To do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Are you wondering why you're being oppressed? Because you chose not to follow the law, statutes, and commandments of your father, right? When you follow the law, statutes, and commandments of your father, you will be what?
And so Jesus
said high above, set thee on high above all nations.
No, you'll be set low.
Set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
right? You would be set high above all nations of the earth.
And without him,
right? So there, if you don't follow the Most High, there's punishment. When you tell your child he has to be inside by a certain time, you tell your daughter she can't talk to boys, and she does, you set a punishment. Well, this is exactly what happened to Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. For not following the voice of the Lord, our power, Yahweh in the Hebrew, we had to go through a punishment, right? We're going to find out what those punishments are, right? You're going to find out why Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are treated terribly in this earth. Because the oppressor hates them, right? Brother, come get a flyer.
Deuteronomy 28 and 15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If you don't listen to the voice of the Lord your God, you're going to go through punishments, right? This is telling you, you need to listen to the voice of the Lord your God. The pastor is going to tell you again, you can eat shrimp, you can eat pork, you can sleep with whatever woman you want, right? The Lord told you the opposite. Let's find out.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
The pastor is going to tell you, you don't have to do the commandments. That's not what it says right here. Read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come.
All these what?
All these curses.
All these good things.
All these curses.
Curses. For not listening to the Lord your God, there's curses. For not keeping his commandments, there's curses. The pastor doesn't want to tell you about these curses. There are curses that you're going to go through.
All these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Right? There are curses that Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans go through. Your pastor is not going to tell you that.
Verse 16. Cursed shall thou be in the city. And cursed
shall thou be where?
In the city.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. How many people have you seen murdered by police? How many times have you gone through oppression in this city? How many times have you been driving and getting pulled over for no reason? Your pastor is not going to tell you why this is happening. He's going to tell you, you can sleep with the oppressor's daughter. He's going to tell the black man, the Hispanic man, and the black and Hispanic Native American woman that they can just sleep with anybody. The pastor is not telling you that. All he wants to do is sing on the corner. He thinks that that's going to help fix black people.
Cursed shall thou be in the city.
Cursed shall y'all be in the city. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you're cursed in this city. Just go to Spadina and Bloor. You'll see Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans sleeping on the curb. You'll see them begging for change. There's a man who put crack cocaine in the black community. There's a man who comes to the black community. They hate you. They're cruel to you. The oppressor, the European man, he is cruel to Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Ask him if he's sorry for what he did. He will say yes, but his words don't mean anything, right? To be sorry, you have to show action, right? You can say you're sorry, but they don't care. The European man and his woman, they benefit off the murder of Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, right? You can plug your ears all you want, but that's not going to stop this truth. That is not going to stop the Lord's plagues. The Lord's plagues are here, and that's why you're walking around with masks. COVID-19 is a plague from the Most High, right? Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, if you don't come back to your God, your power, and follow his commandments, you're going to be victim of his plagues, right?
Deuteronomy 28 and 48. Therefore, shall thou serve thine enemies.
Serve your friends.
Serve thine enemies.
Serve your brothers.
Serve thine enemies.
Serve your lovers.
Thine enemies.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you've loved the oppressor for so long, and he hasn't done anything to show his love back. It's 2021. There's billionaires making rockets to fly into the outer atmosphere of the earth. Native Americans still don't have clean drinking water. Right? They're flying into the outer atmosphere of the earth. There's still crack cocaine in every ghetto you can think of. Right? If they wanted crack cocaine out of the ghetto, they could have did that a long time ago. Read.
which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger and in thirst.
Right? The Lord is setting your oppressors against you. He's setting the European man against you, which you shall serve in hunger and in thirst. Right? Everything you need in life, you have to go to your oppressor. And your oppressor doesn't care. Your oppressor has millions, billions and trillions of dollars. If he wanted to make sure blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans were living comfortably and not under oppression and not going crazy in the barrios, on the reserves, and in the ghettos, he could. But he doesn't want to. He doesn't have a conscience. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, your oppressor does not have love for you. He is the devil the Bible speaks of. All he wants to do is walk around in his Gucci. He wants to make sure that he employs you and you come to him for everything, right? That's the curse in the Bible. Read it again.
Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Your friends you're going to serve. You're going to find out that for not keeping the Lord's commandments, you have to serve your enemies. You want something to eat? Go to No Frills. Guess what? That No Frills is owned by an oppressor. Black, Hispanic, and Native American man, where's your grocery store? Where's your textile? Where's your place? Right? The Christian pastor teaches you that the Lord is all love. The Lord said he hates the oppressor. Read.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee, in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things, and he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
During slavery, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans had a yoke of iron, a dog collar made of steel around their neck. Who put it there? The same person who claims to be who claims to do justice in the earth. The same people that make the laws, they're the ones who put that yoke of iron around your neck. And now, they don't want you to teach that in school. They don't want you to teach the history. They don't want you to teach how they destroyed you. They don't want you to teach how they got power. They don't want you to teach how the European man got all the money in the world, right? He put a yoke of iron around your neck and put you in slavery. He raped and robbed and murdered you. And if you tried to run away or get your freedom, he would cut your foot off. He would cut your hand off. He would whip you.
Until he have destroyed thee, the Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
Right? The European man came from far. The Native Americans did not speak English when they came here. This is a man who was cruel. He didn't know how to farm the land. He didn't know how to survive the winters, right? But they came, the Native Americans, right? The so-called Hispanics, they were kind to our oppressor. Our oppressor is evil. He did evil to our brothers and sisters, right? He took 1,100 of our brothers and sisters, put them on ships, right? And brought them back to Spain. When only 300 of those 1,100 survived, he called it good business. For our oppressor, good business is slavery. You think that you can love your oppressor and love your people at the same time? You can't. How can you love a pedophile and love the person who's being molested at the same time? Brother, if you got a question,
go over there. Go over there.
Right? Right? So you gotta find out who loves you.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the east. From the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle flees, a nation whose son thou shalt not understand.
Right? So you're finding out the oppressor, the devil the Bible speaks of, the European man, the caged beast, right? He represents himself as an eagle. Look at every sign,